also have ministry officials and all other distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I did not want to mention all names in order to save time. So we are back once again for the third time. Mistaken. Last year also we met like similar manner to organize the Tourism Leaders Summit, which is coming up in October. But there are a lot of plans that have been drawn up by the university. I'm thankful to the university group that is here, who are taking a tremendous amount of interest in order to help the ministry, the country, the industry, and the people of Sri Lanka. At the end of the day, what matters is how best tourism could contribute to the Sri Lankan's economy. That is the bottom line. We do everything for the betterment of the country and its people. Betterment of the country is to earn the maximum amount of foreign exchange in order to meet the demands which our leaders are looking forward to implement. On the other hand, for the people, question of employment and sustainability and income generation, etc. So it is a very important combination that has now taken place. Just now we had the exchange between the Minister of Tourism and the university as to how we are going to work together in order to enhance the performance of tourism. The statistics show that billions are crossing borders. The 1.3 billion people for last year and this year have been moving up and down from country to country, crossing borders. And even in Sri Lanka, our numbers have increased that we have all witnessed last year, and it is so continuing this year as well. Therefore, for Sri Lanka, it is very important to understand and study as to how some countries are able to attract millions of tourism. Say, for example, Thailand, or if you take Malaysia, or if you take even Cambodia, a country which has come up the other day, are above us. So there is the question of research that you are engaged, gives a deep sense of contribution to find out in what direction this ministry and these officials will have to move if we are to woo more tourists into this country. From the little knowledge I know, there is no other country that can offer so much of diversity as that of Sri Lanka. We have so much of resources. Though we are an island, comparatively smaller to some of those other countries that are getting millions of tourists, but for a couple of days, diversity we can offer to the tourists is enormous. And with the minimum cost, that is also something that we have to keep in mind. So the university, which is producing academics, they may be who are getting doctorates, or maybe become graduates, are now giving us a postgraduate training to our people in the industry who are passing out from this hotel school and from other institutions. And for those who are already engaged in the tourism business, they may be the owners, or they may be managers, or they may be directors, for them also the opportunity to enhance their knowledge and obtain academic certification. This is important, so that what we cannot depart here to our students can be given from the university because they are having all facilities and they have been recognized. And also they have the capacity of research, which I don't think we have here very much in our hotel schools, excepting the courses and the basic knowledge for the industry being given here. But the research work, as what is done by the university, is the most valuable contribution, I think, that you can do. Therefore, I just listened to the program of action that you have now lined up to celebrate the United Nations World Tourism Day. And it is very, very interesting and very useful to the ministry as well of your plan of action, which sometimes in our ministry and our boards are unable to perform. So that, as far as I can say, we can give you all the support and whatever that you may require from our side in order to have a very successful program to commemorate the United Nations Tourism Day that we are celebrating in October. The fact that you are inviting foreign professors and other speakers to participate on this occasion is, I think, a very useful for our people in the industry to learn and understand of what sometimes we may not be aware. His Excellency the President, if I remember right, has accepted the invitation and he would be present on that day in order to ascertain for himself what contribution the university is making towards the development of tourism in Sri Lanka. As you all know, the government is having tremendous amount of faith in this industry in order to cushion the foreign exchange situation at the moment, which we are, as you know, we are badly indebted due to the past regime, whatever they have done, and now we have to find a large amount of foreign exchange in order to get out of that situation. So this is one area that the government is depending in order to earn that foreign exchange, one, to settle off the old debts, two, to move forward from that point onwards in order to develop this country. So I am really very thankful to our Reverend Vimalaratna and Suranga, who from the very inception are very keen on moving this concept forward. And now I see daily the momentum is increasing, and there will be more people this time joining in the inauguration of the tourism summit. I'm told you have been able to get the main hall, which can accommodate about 1,300. Last year we had a hall which was a limited accommodation. So this we'll be able to invite many sectors who are involved in tourism in Sri Lanka. To a certain extent, the student population, and then there are the other stakeholders in this industry. I think all of them should be brought. Now, yesterday I attended another press conference of culinary. They had another name for it. Chef's Guild. Yes. And I was told that there are 1,000 members who are in the Chef's Guild in Sri Lanka. I was really surprised. And I invited them also to come and join our hotel school and try to depart their knowledge to some of our students who are coming out. See, they are people who have, I don't know, they said they have got awards in the Olympics, not the athletic Olympics, but there is an Olympic event for culinary. It's internationally recognized. So, see, there is a lot of knowledge among our own people for which we have to harness that and bring them together. Like what we are getting from the university, we have to get the practical knowledge of those people who have been been recognized by the international organizations. The other day we had the Bocuse organization, that's another culinary. And ultimately we decided that we should have a separate institution for culinary, teaching that most important thing in tourism is what people come and look for, is accommodation and what the menu they have to enjoy their stay here. So this is considered a very important area, and all of you together will be able to contribute that, and we are all moving in one direction. And in fact, we were thinking whether we could have university status in order to give degree status to some of our children who are passing out, young people from the institute. I think you have been working on it. And sooner we will be able to come out with that facility. We should give encouragement to the boys and girls who are following these courses. Moreover, this will give them not only the opportunity of securing high positions in Sri Lanka, but also to go abroad. Even so, it doesn't matter, because they are our citizens. They will bring their income back to Sri Lanka and bring their experience as well. And I appealed the other day to many of those people who have passed out from this institute, who have now gone abroad, and they are holding very high positions in the Middle East, Far East, and those other countries in the hotels and restaurants, because they went off because there was unrest in the country. Now that there is peace and there is reconciliation, and the two leaders, the President and the Prime Minister, two major parties together, they are working hand in glove without no political differences, that they should come back and come and work in Sri Lanka and help us to develop our industry. As you know, I have been always saying, looking around Colombo, the number of new hotels that are coming up. Every day there is something breaking ground of starting a foundation for a new hotel. And the estimated amount, I've been mentioning even earlier, of rooms to be concluded by next year is about 45,000 rooms. So we require people, personnel, qualified, trained to work in these hotels. At the moment, we are terribly short of it. The demand for a year is about 6,000, but we are now producing only about 3,000 trainees, which is inadequate. So we have to find ways and means of increasing the supply of personnel in order to accommodate the requirements of the hotel that are coming up. There will be the formal sector, there will be the informal sector. Whichever it may be, the tourists are coming. There was a few cancellations this month, but I am told next month it's all full. The next 2-3 months, and then we come to the season, to the end of the year, and we will go above the expectations or the estimates that we have for this year. Already 1.2 million tourists have arrived. Within the next 5-6 months, we are quite certain that we'll have another at least 1.3 million coming in, which brings us to about 2.5 million arrivals. That's not enough. If you look at a few countries in the Far East, we are nowhere. They are running into millions, 20 million, 30 million, 40 million, as I mentioned earlier. Cambodia, which is a country that came up the other day, last year they have recorded 5 million tourists. I went there to see what it is magic about it. There's nothing to see there, except in some old buildings, some heritage sites. Even that, there is no proper access to those places. But they have been quite good at marketing, and as a result of it, there's a line of tourists that are pouring into that country. So there is no reason why we should not have, or above those numbers, it can be easily done. So with the support of the university and with their knowledge and their research, training, additional training and knowledge departing to the students who are passing out from this institution and those of you, others who are already engaged in the hospitality, can enhance their knowledge and practices in order to satisfy the demands of those tourists who are coming into our country. So there are so many ways that we can move forward. One way is by the help of the university. That is why we look at you, and we are very happy that you are taking a very keen interest in order to work hand in glove with the Minister of Tourism for the betterment and welfare of the country. That's the ultimate aim that we have to keep in mind, especially our Reverend Vimal Ratna. He's been part of this. He's very encouraging, and I'm sure next year we'll be able to have a graduate status in this profession. Not only postgraduate, but also provide the opportunity for our boys and girls who are passing out from here in order to acquire a degree status. Thank you very much. And pi singaling hema mukut kathawak honada api sesema kolamba vishwavidyale avilain ape garuthara nayaka swamin wahanse athu